everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Nao Nails. In this video, we are going to do Lion King nails because obviously it's been revamped.
Yeah, well, remake.
Yeah, it's a remake of it.
Sort of made into real
people. Made into real people. Yeah.
Real people?
Real people.
Well, animals. Real animals. Yeah.
But not real.
But not real. Yeah,
animated.
Oh, that was
real.
So weird when you said that yeah. together because you sounded exactly the same. Like stereo.
I'm with my mum today. My mum's having Lion King nails. How amazing is that? Adam's a massive fan of Lion King because of his son, basically.
Mm-hmm. I've seen it a billion times. It was the first film that he ever watched, and it's still his favourite.
It's stuck. Yeah, so it'll be cool. On my mother's nails, I have removed my mum's nails. Not her real ones, obviously.
That would be painful.
Yeah.
Torture.
I removed, you had on this hand, you had the Love Island ones on, didn't you?
Yeah.
Love Island's very good at the minute. It's getting a bit of drama. But yeah, we're going to go Lion King today. So we're going to sculpt these out. You're not going to go massively long, are you, then, mum? Because you don't super long nails.
I don't know why.
What shape are we going to do, Mum?
Whatever shape you like. Choose whatever one you like. But not really pointy.
So, should we do like a bit of a soft square?
Yeah.
Slightly tapered.
Are they good for gardening?
Well, it's going to have a soft end on it. Soft edge. Honest to God, I go round my mum's and I look at her nails and I'm like, I'll be wearing gloves again. She's got soil underneath and all sorts of...
What do you shovel up with?
I know.
All sorts of nastiness.
Getting your weeds out.
Oh, so you use them as tools then? It's supposed to be jewels, not tools. You using the nails to do your grout and things like that? No. No, guys. Not what you're supposed to be doing. My mum does everything. Like, she's always busy. She's never sat down. She's forever being told to sit down. Especially by Mick, aren't you?
Oh, yes.
Just sit down. Stop doing stuff.
Can't be doing with that sitting down business.
Do you want to be the cameraman then? I never get to have a sit down.
So you notice that I'm opening the back a little bit on these forms, which I don't do if I'm doing a stiletto or an almond. And I'm opening the back just to raise the form slightly, just to get a slightly better C curve, because we're going to go a bit square. Just checking that they're all closed right underneath that finger. So they're all nice and snug. And we're going to do the four fingers first and then we will move to the thumb. Because if you notice, the hand rests like that and then the thumb will touch the desk. I don't want to knock the form. We're going to bring this cushion forward. This cushion is actually a lumbar support. People have asked me a lot about this cushion. They say, where have you had your cushion, your wrist rest, arm rest, whatever you want to call it. It's a lumbar support cushion. So it's supposed to go behind your back and it's memory foam. Yeah, keep it like that. So we're going to dehydrate now. So you can see, obviously, I've already prepped my mum's nails. We did a removal last night. God knows what time.
Silly o'clock.
Watching Love Island.
Well, we weren't watching Love Island, but Cass was watching
Cass was, yeah.
We were.
I couldn't watch it properly, so I had a debrief. Izzy debriefed me on everything that had happened.
I could imagine, like, Izzy and Cass just being best mates.
I tell you what, Izzy always says she should have been my child. Because they are so alike. It's unbelievable. Gonna use high speed just to do the thin layer of clear because I just want a very thin layer of clear. I'm gonna be using a lot of colours that are super highly pigmented and I want there to be great adhesion between the acrylic and my mum's nail. So clear is definitely great for that. Plus, these are not strength products, they are there for purely colour. So this clear layer will give strength as well. And I'm using high speed just because we're going to do quite a small nail. So a thin layer on the nail bed. Sorry, the nail plate itself. I'm going to bring it down. Making sure it's nice and thin. Is that one all right there, Mum?
That one?
That there, that going to that length.
Go on then.
Oh, she looked a bit traumatised. Oh, dear.
That looks long.
It's not. Do you know what? The ones we took off last night were about that length. So we're going to do this to all of these nails. Nice thin layer. Take that bit off.
You know, I should take these time, these moments here to ask your mum questions about you.
I think you should, yeah.
I should. Like, how? What was the worst trouble that Kirsty ever got into when she was a kid?
Oh dear.
Don't know if that can be televised.
No, too many to be told. No.
Don't know if it can be televised.
No. Terrible.
Is there anything that can be televised?
That's very difficult. Try and think.
Is she a bit of a wild child?
Yes.
Do you think I was?
Well,
I thought I was a good kid compared to some people I know.
Yes, you were. You were, really. But a lot of things I didn't even find out till after, did I?
Like that, what?
You know, going home and spending the day at home eating super noodles, chicken super noodles.
What, were you supposed to be at school?
Well, they're supposed to be at school. I wondered why my super noodles were going down so fast. All the friends were eating them.
Oh, God.
You weren't too bad. Only, you know, when you were left alone with a babysitter. The babysitter the babysitter was as bad. Yeah. It was the older cousin.
Ah, right.
Yes.
Joanne.
I had an older cousin called Joanne who used to babysit me.
Oh, yes. They used to shove her down the stairs in a suitcase. Fasten it. And then I wondered why I'd got all holes at the bottom of the stairs and the wall. I don't know how it's happened. Later, found out that they were sliding down the stairs in a suitcase. Mainly it was Kirsty.
Done it in sleeping bags, never in a suitcase.
Oh dear.
Yeah.
Oh, we did have some fun. So we've got Caribbean Sunsplash, Mango Fizz, Fizzy Mango, I think it said actually. Tangerine Sorbet, Wild Strawberry, and this is my favourite, which is Vivid Violet, hence we have quite a humongous pot of it. So I am pinching these as I go, just to give them a little bit more of a sneak. Well, you will tell stories about me. I'm going to get rid of the high speed. I'm going to switch to medium now. I want a little bit more time with my colours, because we're going to do a bit of a sunset ombre. And because it's quite a small nail.
Sunrise, not sunset.
Sunrise early in the morning. That's the wrong song.
Completely the wrong song.
What's he say? So the sun will be at the tip. Small bead, blend up. Just want to get your tip nice and neat. And then you'll see we are going to go slightly orange. We are overlapping the colours. Oh, a nice colour. I do like the fact that some of these have got, like, you know, these particles of glitter in as well. It makes it not so flat. You could do this in just like a pure colour, but I think that this just helps it not be so flat. Just going to put a little bit more of that on. Oof, look at that colour, that is. And you want to make sure you're sort of sweeping them down nice and thin, which will help when you do your ombre. My mum is a little bit of a fake client, you know.
Really?
Fake client?
A little bit, because you go, oh, what about that bit? What about that bit? But yeah, my mum says it in the nicest possible way.
I'm just looking now.
I could see my mum then thinking, that's a little gap there.
Yeah, yeah.
I could see her looking at the screen thinking,
yeah. Don't quite.
I've filled it in. But like, sometimes she'll say it and I'm like, I'm going to do it. I can see it. I have eyes. So because the vivid violet is so vivid, we are going to add a little bit of the wild strawberries over that to blend. I'm going to soften this back a little bit with some natural, nice and thin. Then I'm going to cap it in clear. So what we're doing is we are sandwiching the colours between the clear acrylic. So I'm going to take the forms off now. Nice, don't you, them colours?
Yeah, I like them colours.
Nice and sunny.
Yeah, they are. Mm.
Nice and bright.
Yeah, they'd be nice just like that, with a bit of bling.
They would. So, I'm going to file them now. I'm going to do my normal filing routine. On this one, I don't know if I'm happy with this blend, so I might end up just adding a little bit of product onto it just to change this blend at the cuticle. Sorry, Mum.
Oh, yeah, you don't like this bit, do you?
No, don't like it at all. The filing. The feel.
I'll do some of it with e-file for you, Mum, because I know you prefer that, don't you?
Yes, I don't like. I don't like any filing.
Oh, I can't get away with not doing.
Isn't there anything that you can?
Well, there's the dual forms, but it doesn't allow you as much freedom as using. Like, you know, using all the colours and everything.
It's
like
being the dentist.
It is not.
It is.
So I don't like the blend on this, so I've filed down quite low. So I'm sort of hitting those two colours and removing some of the bulk. And I think I don't like it because it was too hard. So what I'm gonna do, which is what I've kind of done as I've gone along, is can you see how it's not?
What do you mean it's too hard?
It's too hard, like it's not blended nice enough. It's not soft, like a soft blend.
There's no gradient, is there? It's yeah. Just two
so I've gone right down, which obviously makes it even more blocky. But what I have been doing is I've been getting this colour, which is Tangerine Sorbet, and I've been putting that over the top of the Wild Strawberries, which is this colour, and it blends it nicely. So I'm just going to add a tinsy bit of Vivid Violet.
So did you forget to do it on that one? Or didn't you put enough on?
I think that I just needed to learn as I go and figured out that it kind of needed this colour because it's transparent as well. It's not completely transparent because it has a transparent quality to it. The blend is better. So see how it's a little bit transparent? It's not completely solid. And when we put that over, you still get the vibrantness from the Wild Strawberries. But then this colour actually blends it a lot nicer. See the difference? It's easier to blend with as well. I'm still going to put that tiny bit of natural on. And a little smidge of clear.
You know what they remind me of? What? Them round trees lollies.
Ooh, yeah. So while that's setting, I can continue to file the rest of the nails. So we're going to buff the nails now, make them nice and smooth. Yeah, so now you can see that this blend looks a lot better at the back. We've just got that hint of purple. Because what I did was I was Googling sunsets and sunrises, and some of them have got this bit of purple, and I just think it really lifts the... Because imagine if it was just that. Yes, it'd look nice, but I think that adding that purple just lifts the design. I And also, if my mum has an accident and bruises a nail at the back, well, it'll just look the same, won't it?
Digging out plants.
Yeah. Well,
with no gloves on.
With no gloves on. Weeding with my nails.
So I'm just going to wipe over with acetone. You can use gel residue wipe off solution as well. So when you're doing design work on nails, you need to always think about the length of the nail as well. So my mum's nails are not really long. If I was doing a really long set, like with Faye, I would use do little portraits, little character painting, like I have done with the Aladdin nails that we did. So I would go into a lot of detail because obviously we've got a bigger surface, more canvas to work on, yeah. So we haven't got a great, massive, big canvas, but who says shorter, nails can't have artwork on? Well, they can. So we're going to do silhouettes. So it'll still be Lion King themed, but we're going to use the black and do the silhouettes. So we're going to use black paint.
Look at that new tube of black paint.
I do love a new tube of paint. So I was Googling the topic, and I really love this because we've got Mufasa and Simba. And yes, it's a bit detailed, so we'll see how we go. So I'm just gonna put some little marks of where I want it to start and finish. So his foot's gonna be there. And actually, we're gonna cut off a little bit of him. So as I look at this, let me get two buffers so you can see. We're going to cut this bit off to make it narrower, but I might just sneak his little tail coming up there. So we'll slightly adjust it and fit this on the nail. So this is what I'm looking for now. When I put these marks on, that's where the back leg of Mufasa will be. And then this leg here needs to sit just over halfway. Sort of there. Then it's going to come up. Top of his head will be about there. And his chest will come out to about there. So we've got some little marks now to work from. I am going to water the paint down and make more of a wash to start to map out. I'm going to outline Simba. I don't think I'll get all of Simba on there. If we go any smaller, we're not really going to see that it is Simba. Thank you. I'm going to outline Mufasa. Or is it Mufasa? Is it Simba when he's older?
You never know, it could be. You're looking into it deeply.
Rafiki. Right, so we're going to do Rafiki now. So let's do a staff first. It'd be a good starting point. What's Rafiki got tied round?
Yeah, it's like I don't know whether it's not shells, but like husks of like, it looks like coconut husks.
Yeah.
And he has stuff in them.
Magical stuff. Oh, I'm loving this already. I'm loving Rafiki.
We best seal these.
I won't knock them.
Are you sure?
No, it's just paint.
Famous last words.
Think I'm going to knock them?
I just got a feeling.
Shall we seal them?
Yeah.
Because now you've tainted it.
Sorry, but I'm thinking. Well, if you knock them and you haven't sealed them, I would have sealed after each one.
Okay. Told you she was a bit of a fae.
I think you need your own channel, Pam.
Have you seen my mum's video in techniques?
Shut up.
Oh, you did? You showed me it?
Oh, sure. Mind the mess.
Is it on?
Is it on? Yeah, is it on? Oh, mind the mess. Oh, we're just doing the fireworks for Mick. Pop that in, Mother.
Thank you.
So we're going to do, which one's Pumbaa, which one's Timon?
Timon's the little meerkat.
So we're going to do Timon. So funny. You know what? The musical is amazing, and the guys that play Pumbaa and Timon are just amazing. They're so funny. Yeah, they play the part so well, and the costumes.
I think it's touring up in our area at some point this year, so I think I'm going to go and see it.
So he's snout. So we'll top coat the rest now, Mother. We're not going to knock them. Out of all of the nails...
You like the tree.
I do really like the tree, but I like Rafiti.
Yeah.
I do. I like him. Him, her.
Him.
Whoever. Yeah.
Oh, it's a her in the musical.
Is it?
Well, it's a woman that plays it.
Really?
Yeah. Big African woman. Very good. So we have a little tree, Rafiti, Simba and Mufasa. Or is it Simba and Simba when he's older?
Timon.
And Pumbaa. And they'd be nice for change up. You can change up that design quite easily and put other stuff on as well because you've got that gorgeous ombre in the background.
Yeah, I like the colours.
Beautiful.
And a bit of sparkle in it.
Yeah, the sparkle in the background.
Yeah, the sparkle's nice because it's like, it's the sunset's glimmering like in the background, isn't it?
Yeah. There you are, guys. Hope you enjoyed our Lion King inspired nails. Everything I've used today will be listed below. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. So, that's all.
And then let's have a party. Let's throw the jelly at the ceiling.
On the spoon.
The walls. Yeah. Kitchen ceiling covered in jelly.
Are you doing the same thing?
No.
No.
I'm doing some trees.
Mufasa, quick, stop peeing at the gorge. Shimmer's down there.
Okay. Let's go.